Hey guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome back to Taito Ecology. In the last episode, we checked out our rainforest biome for the first time after the 1.9 update, only to find that everything had died. All of our animals had passed away because the detritus levels were out of control, and it turns out that it wasn't entirely our fault. On the same day that I posted that video, the developers actually released a hotfix for the 1.9 update, which fixes certain issues with animals prioritizing these delicious mushrooms over all of the other plants and leaves in the area. So it sounds like our agoutis probably did eat all of our mushrooms while we were away, and then the detritus just spiked and everyone got sick and died, but it looks like the grasslands have been saved. We don't have that problem here to worry about, and it seems like most of our creatures are still alive. The one thing I want to check are the wolves over here in particular, because we have done so well at keeping them alive. But wait a second. Okay, there they are. Oh my goodness, that worried me a little bit. They are still alive, but there's only one baby left. What? One little baby wolf. Oh my gosh, that is really sad. I hope you're okay, little baby wolf. I'm not sure where you are. Oh my goodness, we're going to have to try to hunt that guy down at some point, but let's see what sort of notifications we have up here. They were fixed now, so all of your notifications should be just where they're supposed to be. It looks like some bobcats had trouble. The mule deer had trouble. Actually, wait a second. Are her deer mice gone? Oh my goodness, I think we may have completely exterminated the deer mice, guys. Oh my goodness. Okay, I see a couple over there, but I am not worried about four little tiny groups of deer mice. Oh my goodness. Okay, five. Five. There's one peeking out of the tree right there trying to confuse me, but there's one baby deer mouse in that territory. There's one in there. There's one in there, and there's one in there. Oh my gosh, these are just tiny little baby deer mice just skittering around in my land at the moment. Let's see if I can click on this one. There we go. There's one adult there. Oh my gosh. So there's like one lone adult deer mouse taking care of this tiny little brood of babies. That is a little bit unfortunate for them, but honestly, I am so happy to see that. That is like the best news I have had in this game for a long time. Our deer mouse situation has been taken care of, and there's one right now, one of the last deer mice of the entire biome. You, sir, are a menace. You are a lot of trouble. Hopefully, next time we place a full group of deer mice in the area, we won't have that sort of trouble. Hopefully we'll be able to control them this time as we try to rebuild this place. But the cougars are having a grand time in here, aren't they? This guy in particular is very, very happy. Unfortunately, with all of the deer mice gone, that means that they don't have the same type of food that they did before. So I think that's what we're going to have to work on right now. We're going to have to try to figure out how we can salvage this place as far as our carnivores go, how we can keep them all happy and healthy as well for the months that are going to pass while we're gone. So let's see. I am not going to add any deer mice in yet until we are completely 100% sure that these guys are totally gone. As they slowly die off, slowly continue to disappear from the biome. So that's good news, guys. That's all good news. I think we'll probably add some jackrabbits in here because I'm sure our little baby wolf will be very happy to have a little bit of bunny to eat in the morning. Hopefully we can find that guy too. I know the wolves have some pretty large territories, so I wouldn't be surprised if he's not roaming around in this area, this lovely forest that we built for all of our wolves. But hopefully we'll find him in this episode. I'm sure he's lurking around here somewhere. It looks like the deer have actually taken over in the wolf's absence. And it seems like, okay, there's two more groups of deer mice who are totally gone. So in this episode, we may just see the deer mice completely go extinct in this biome, which honestly I am so happy about. So we have two left, it looks like, and I didn't see any more anywhere else in the biome. It seems like we are down to two territories, and those territories just had little tiny baby mice, so I think we're doing good. We'll replenish our fish population too, because something definitely likes to eat the fish out of this little pond here. Probably one of our big cats, I would assume. Maybe this cougar is gonna come over here now and try to fish. Though I was having a little bit of trouble with the animals actually getting stuck in this water. Hopefully that's not why some of these are dying off. We'll place a couple more jackrabbits over here. Oh my goodness, we finally are going to be able to replenish all of the grass in this area too. That is excellent, guys. We're going to be able to try to restore this area to its previous glory. I think I may place some different types of plants in here other than grass, because if you take a look around, we pretty much are exclusively grass at the moment. I know it makes sense because this is the grasslands, but I would like to spruce it up just a little bit more than that. We do have some trees in the area, which once upon a time our deer mice like to munch on. I don't want to place too many jackrabbits here just because I don't want them to go out of control. I have a tendency to do that, to place too many of one type of animal, and then they just kind of all reproduce at the same time and then branch off into different colonies, and our carnivores can't keep up with them, which is the main problem here. And oh my goodness, look how many jackrabbits are in one territory too. This is crazy. They almost look like little mushrooms around here, but they are jackrabbits. They are certainly our jackrabbits, and they are all curling up for a nice nap in the grass, which is adorable. So let's see, what sort of grass can we place in here today? Or not grass, plants. We'll place some milk vetch over here. How close can I get it to the tree? About right there. There we go. We want to pack all of this in. Oh, that's the milkweed. This is actually a poisonous plant, which is why it's the only plant that is still in this area, because the deer mice actually couldn't eat it. So I'm not really sure how helpful this is going to be to our biome, but we'll place a little bit more in. Why not? I guess that's okay. It spruces it up just like I wanted to do, right? We could try the prairie blazing star. That might look nice. A little bit of a different pop to the biome. We'll place a couple of those, actually, because they have those nice purple little blooms on them there. There we go. And we have our tiny little moths right next to them too, so they should be able to help them spread all around this zone here, eventually anyway. And it looks like one of our badgers are down here too. One of these big badgers. I wonder what he's coming to eat. Oh my gosh, he's already full, so I have a feeling that all of our snakes have probably died off now too. I knew they were having trouble because, oddly enough, the carnivores seem to prefer eating the snakes over like the tiny deer mice and the jackrabbits and stuff. So I'm not sure. They probably have all died off. We'll try to add a couple more back in and see if we can keep them alive, but I don't have much hope for that after seeing the way that they were completely demolished before. We'll place some of this skunkbush sumac in the area because I don't think we have many of them, do we? Some of the animals must have eaten them away. We have a couple over here, but otherwise, I think this area is pretty bare of skunk bush sumacs. So we'll place some right over here as well, right next to our little jackrabbits that we just placed down. And we should probably think about speeding up the time a little bit too to gather up those impact points while we're waiting to place more things down. I have a ton of Taito coins up here too because I was experimenting with different biomes on my own. And we can use that to gather up some more impact points in the meantime. So I'll probably do that. I'll just get a couple of those, and then we'll place some of these lovely flowers down here. We'll have to zoom in to see them, unfortunately, though. Let's see. Hopefully they'll bloom pretty soon. I think we have some pollinators in the area, right? I think so. Yeah, of course, we have our moths right here. We have moths over here, and both of them can definitely reach these lovely flowers, so we'll make a tiny little flower field, I think. That'll be pretty cute. A little flower field over here for animals to run around in and enjoy in this area that used to be taken over by deer mice, so a bit of a lovelier view than all of those tiny deer mice skittering through the grass. Pretty soon we'll have tiny white blossoms on all of these little plants, and I think it'll be very, very nice. So there we go. Hopefully the rest of the plants can spread around this area, and maybe next time we come here, it'll be all nice and colorful and full. I am a little bit worried that maybe I have too much grass in the area. We could use some nice herbivores to come in and kind of graze this place a little bit because there is a lot of grass. Again, I know it makes sense because we are in the grasslands, but it is quite a bit to deal with. So let's see if we can place maybe some deer around here, because again, I know that our little wolves would enjoy that, and I believe our cougars would too. So we'll place some antelope right over here this time. We'll place them over here a little bit further away from this water trap on this side, because the deer in particular seem very prone to getting themselves stuck in that water. So we'll place the antelope over here as well, right next to our other cougars, in fact, so they'll probably enjoy that. And it looks like, again, we're just down to two deer mice over here. This guy, this one juvenile, and this juvenile. So, unfortunately, guys, I think you're on your way out. And, oh my goodness, we actually have one snake left. I think this might be, like, literally the only snake left in the biome. Just one little snake. And it looks like some of the grass is already spreading around, so that's pretty neat. It seems like it's slowly filling all of those gaps. This area is still having a little bit of trouble spreading, it seems like. It may have slowly started. I'm not sure. This may have crept into the territory. And there we go. Look at all of those flowers, guys. Isn't that nice? That's so much better than all of those mice that were here before. And it looks like another group may have died. So actually, were those all? Those are all practically deer mice notifications. So I don't know. I'm glad to see that because it was pretty bad before. And yep, there we go. We're down to one more deer mouse, guys. One more deer mouse. And it's hungry for some reason. There we go. It always seems so strange to me when the herbivores say that they're hungry. I mean, they literally have an entire field to choose from. There is so much grass in the area here. I don't know what they're getting on about. Here's our cougar, of course, already taking down some of our antelope, so that's good to see. They definitely appreciate the fact that we place so many antelope in the area. And what is their reproduction cycle like, I wonder? Let's see, 51 weeks. So I don't think we're going to have to really worry about them going out of control in these 6 months that we're gone, because I don't think it'll really be possible for them. this one has four groups left, so it is in low population at the moment. But honestly, that's not too bad. Did I just see? Okay, yeah, this is what I was talking about. This guy is stuck over here, right at the bank, and I'm pretty sure that he can't exactly get out. So that guy might be having a little bit of trouble pretty soon. Our fish, somebody is really eating our fish. Is it you, Mr. Antelope? I don't think that's a good idea for you. You are an herbivore. You should not be eating fish. It must be, maybe the baby wolf is around here somewhere. Would wolves like to eat fish? I'm not sure. The deer mice are starving again. Like, that is so weird. That is absolutely insane. We know that that mouse is probably not stuck in this water either, because he's way too far away to get stuck in here. But let's see if we can find what is actually eating all of those fish, because I would like to see what could possibly be doing that. I'm not sure if they need to be by the waterside to eat them or not. I'm not sure if the game does that, but look at that. Okay, there's a cougar right by the water, so I bet this is the guy. This is the one who's eating all of our fish right now. What are you going to kill? Oh, those are those jackrabbits, of course. Already picking our jackrabbit population clean, which is just fine because the jackrabbits actually reproduce very quickly as well. I have learned that. The jackrabbits tend to reproduce just as fast as the deer mice, so we are going to have to keep a very close eye on these guys to make sure that they don't decide to go off the rails like the deer mice. We don't want them to become the second deer mice of the grasslands biome. Honestly, I have had so much trouble with the grasslands, more so than any of the other biomes, just trying to keep all of these tiny critters under control for whatever reason. And oh my goodness, it looks like we have tiny baby trees again. The tiny honey mesquites. 201 weeks until they reach maturity, which makes sense because trees take a very long time to grow. And this one, oh my goodness, you guys, look at that. Our big eastern cottonwood had a little baby tree. So that's what spread around. And is this another one back here? Goodness. Oh my gosh, that is adorable. We're actually making our own little forest over here instead of just grass, which is nice. I do like shaking things up every now and then. And oh my goodness, look at all these badgers. Did the badgers have babies? Oh my gosh, that's the badger that I put in the tree, you guys. They have survived so well. Six juveniles. Okay, maybe that is the way to do it after all. Maybe you just need to like plop a big tree on your badger territory and then they will be just fine. Living inside this tree has definitely paid off for them. Maybe they can like scoop up all of the little bugs that crawl around on the bark or something. That is very interesting that badger territory in particular has done so well for itself. That's good to see. And they're all curled up in the flowers. How cute is that? Oh my gosh, these little baby badgers sleeping next to jackrabbits too. I'm not sure if they would like to munch on the jackrabbits, honestly. I'm really not sure if that's something that they would enjoy. But I do kind of want to place some more bobcats in the area because I know that they were struggling while we were gone. I believe they're actually all dead at the moment, which is a bit unfortunate. So we'll place some bobcats right there. Unfortunately, they're going to be living right next to our lone cougar. So that may be a little bit of an issue. I'm sure they're going to be battling for territory at some point. But oh my goodness, was that our last deer mouse, guys? Was that our last deer mouse? Yes, it was. I think it was. No, it wasn't. What? They got me so excited, but the cougar was actually hiding the deer mouse. Oh my gosh. Well, what is dying then? That is very strange. The deer mice are starving and whatnot, but I don't know where they're starving from. We are in zone 5 right now, unless they're like outside of the boundaries or something. Or maybe their territories are invisible, like the bison territory. I'm still not exactly sure where the bison territory is. I'm not sure if maybe they've died off by now because the bison tend to go very quickly for whatever reason. I think the cougars and the wolves really love to munch away at those bison, so it makes it hard to kind of keep them alive for very long. Oh, the prairie dogs! We haven't seen these guys in so long, have we? Oh my goodness, let's place some prairie dogs in the area. We'll place them in all of this grass over here because I'm sure they're going to enjoy that. Yeah, the prairie dogs, guys. We started with the prairie dogs when we began our journey in the grasslands, but of course, I got so distracted with those awful deer mice that I just wasn't able to replenish their populations. So now we can finally see the prairie dogs again. Look at these guys. No, not the mushrooms, not the mushrooms. We want to click on the prairie dogs. Oh, they're so cute, and they're dropping in at 2 years old, so that's good to note. If they ever have babies, then we'll know which ones are the babies and which ones aren't. They have 52 weeks until they can reproduce, so they are definitely not as fast as the bunnies or the deer mice, but they will eventually be reproducing, so that would be nice to see. Hopefully we can keep them alive for that long. That's a long time, kind of like the deer over here too. They take quite a while, though honestly, with the way that this game is so fast-paced now, it's really going down fast. I'm pretty sure that was at like 50 weeks before. Let's see, 2 weeks left until these guys reproduce. Oh my goodness, I am starting to wonder if we should add some more carnivores in here before we end out the episode. That might be a good idea. I'm not sure if we need to or not, though. This group over here, oh my goodness, is this cougar coming in here to hunt down our little wolf pup? Oh my goodness, either he's picking off all of these deer over here, which may be the case because I'm sure he is quite hungry and the deer are a good meal for cougars, or he's looking for that wolf pup to finally eradicate his enemies over here, because we have read that the big cats will kill a wolf pup if given the chance, because it's just one less bit of competition for them later on in life. So let's see, I think we probably should add another group of wolves into this area just to give that one little wolf pup some hope, just to help them hang on in the 6 months that are going to pass. And there again, as we place these guys in, they're immediately having a little bit of trouble. I swear, like, they drop these guys in really, really hungry, and then they have to go rush off and find some food or something. I'm not sure. They must have just had a very rough trip over, and now they're enjoying their time in our biome right away. So that's good. That's very good to see that, oh, there it is! There's the wolf pup, guys! Oh my gosh, you should not be stalking this cougar. That is not going to end well. That is definitely the wolf pup. I like how he's kind of like returning to this area because we just dropped all of those other wolves in. So he's kind of like checking out these guys. Oh my gosh, that is so cute. They're coming over to like check out the little wolf pup to take them in under their wings at the moment to see if they could add them to their pack. There you go. You are going to have some wonderful friends here, so you won't be all alone for 6 whole weeks. or 6 whole months, rather. 6 whole months, not 6 weeks. 6 weeks would be an easy way to play this, but we're doing 6 months, which is actually normal mode. If we wanted to go hard mode here, we could pass the entire year while we're gone, which I have toyed with. I have considered doing that for maybe the Himalayas, but I have a feeling that that place would go completely off the rails if I had one entire year passing before we returned to it. So let me know what you guys think, if you think I should possibly do that, because it is such a big biome anyway that I thought maybe we should just go all in for that one. Go all in with the biggest option that we possibly can. This cougar, he's moving so slow through this little forest here, but I have a feeling he has his eye on some of these antelope. I think I do want to place a couple more groups of deer here too. I think I'll go ahead and look for the mule deer this time and place this guy in. And hopefully that will help keep all of our carnivores properly fed in the 6 months that are going to pass. Of course, we have a ton of mushrooms in the area. We have some little earthworms too, so I don't think we're really going to have to worry about the decomposers dying off, especially now that the developers made that little hotfix for them, which definitely helped. It obviously helped because all of the mushrooms were still here when I came back, so I'm very glad to see that. And I haven't had any notifications today about mushrooms dying, so definitely fix that. Definitely fix that issue. And there's the bison. There you are, sir. You have survived for a very long time, but I wonder if that's because nobody can find your territory. The one lone bison who's just hanging around here without a home to call to his name. So I'm not sure what's going on with him, but I'm glad to see that he's still alive. Hopefully it'll stay that way, even though we've, placed this wolf in here. What are you doing, sir? I think he might just be going after the fish, actually. Yeah, okay, so we'll replenish those before we leave. So hopefully these guys will have plenty to eat in the meantime as the bison goes charging through the water, getting out of here, getting right out of here. Doesn't want anything to do with these wolves, which you can definitely understand. So I think that's about it for this episode. We'll go back up to our wolves up here so we can watch them, hopefully. Hopefully they're still in the area anyway, because it seems like they kind of all scattered after they met that wolf pup. There they are. There they are, at least one of them. So hopefully in the next episode, or at least the next time we come back to the grasslands, we'll see that all of the deer mice have officially died off. I have a feeling that it's going to go that way because I can't imagine that that tiny deer mouse, that one lone baby deer mouse, is going to be able to survive 6 whole months in this biome with all of these big predators roaming around in the grass for it. So we'll have to see, guys. We'll have to see. But thank you guys so much for watching today, and I will see you all next time. Bye!